Hi everyone, I'm Jayne at Rockin' Worms. Hope you're having a good evening. What I'm going to be working on tonight is just, you know, a regular grow out bin, sifting, feeding, seeing what's going on with them. So let's get into the bin. I have had this section open on the bin for approximately 5 days to start drying it down. It's also very thin. A very thin layer of bedding in here, okay? And you can see there's still, you know, some unprocessed bedding because all the worms have moved out and down into the covered more moist area, leaving behind this bedding. Okay, and castings, of course. So you can hear, I don't know if you can hear it. All right, that's kind of how dry this bedding is. So I was actually a little concerned that I had left the bedding too long before I sifted it, but I think I'm okay because here's a handful of bedding. I'm squeezing, you know, firmly, not gently, but not like cranking on it, and it's still holding together. So whew, there's enough moisture in there. The bacteria that is in the castings should still be fine, okay. And again, since this is just a small amount that I was drying down, let's see if I can get it all in one sift. All right, let's see. Probably good enough. Okay, let's sift and see what we get. Just as a reminder, this is a 1/8 inch screen on top and a 1/12 inch screen on the bottom. I like using both screens because the 1/12 will catch any worms that, you know, kind of quickly wiggle down. They'll also catch a lot of the cocoons, all right? And I don't wanna have to be digging through my castings at the bottom of a bucket or a pot in this case to rescue worms or cocoons. It's just much easier to do it at a higher level, which the 1/12 screen gives me. Okay, so here is, you know, what didn't go through, which looks fine. This is actually part of, I think, a star fruit. I had a bunch of star fruit I processed, and I put the skins and the ridges in, and I don't think, honestly, I'm gonna be doing that again because they're taking forever to break down, and they were frozen and defrosted, but they're still taking forever. Anyways, okay, so this is the material that went through the 1/8, but not the 12th. What I'm doing right now is just doing a little quick look through to see if I see any cocoons. I don't get a lot of cocoons in my grow out bins, so not seeing any or just one or two is not surprising to me. I'm not seeing any. And, you know, if a couple of cocoons go into my castings bucket and out to my garden, I'm okay with that. So what I'm going to do, oh, here's a cocoon right here, right there. See it? Yep. What I'm going to do is I'm going to gently pick it up. Oop, couldn't get it. You know what? I lost it. Oh, I lost it. It's okay. It's in there. It's fine. Like I said, it can go out to the garden. Oh, here it is. Ha! Okay, I'm gently picking up. Now I've got it. And I'm going to just put it down in the working end of the bin. It's going to get mixed up and moved down when I do the kind of pseudo wedge method. But okay, so I had one cocoon. I'm good with that. All right, so what I'm going to do is give you a quick look at the 1/12 inch castings, how fine and beautiful these are. This is how small worm poop really is when it gets down to its, you know, more dried level, and it's more individual grains than it is, you know, clumped together with other pieces of castings. So I'm going to take this 1/8 inch sifted material castings, and I'm just going to dump it in here because I don't have any cocoons or very few cocoons in there. And I'm gonna put this right in my castings bucket, which will go out to the garden. All right, so I'm just gonna set that aside for now. Let's get back into the bin and see what else is going on. Taking off the plastic moisture barrier, looking at the newspaper, ton of mites in here. What I like to do when I have a big grouping of mites on a piece of newspaper like this is I tear it off and I put it in a container and I just set it aside. And then I also will do a little scoop out here of this little bunch of mites, put it in the same container, little scoop out here. This is newspaper and on some castings on the top. And do I got anybody else in here? That's a little bit, that's not so bad. I'll grab it anyways, why not? Okay, all right, that's good enough, all right? Mites in your worm bin, you know, not a problem unless it gets out of control. Certainly the amount I have in here is not excessive, so I'm not worried about it. But when I can grab a whole bunch easy, like I just did, I put it in a container like this. And then tomorrow, when the sun is out, I'll go put this in a little block of sunshine for, you know, an hour or until I remember and I go back out and get it. And what it will do is, do I have a worm in there? Oh, look at, I have a worm. I'm gonna put him right back in. Okay, and here's another one. Okay, oh my gosh, there's a couple in here. Okay, I'm just gonna have to go through more closely. Yeah, we don't wanna bake those worms out there in that sunshine, do we? Okay, but look, you can see the mites. This is a good picture of mites. Okay, so yeah, so I'm gonna put this out in a block of sunshine for an hour or a couple until I get back to it. And what that's gonna do is dry out the mites and, you know, kill them. And then what I'm gonna do is put this material dried with the dead mites back into the worm bin. And that's gonna provide these worms with valuable chitin, which is the material that the exoskeletons of the mites are made out of, is chitin, C-H-I-T-I-N. And that chitin the worms use to make the worm segments, you know, the little bandings that you see when you look at worms, that little banding is made out of chitin, okay? So it is a valuable resource that the worms need. And this is one way of getting it, right? So I'm just gonna set that aside because that's gonna go out tomorrow. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is just start seeing what I've got for worms in here and moving them down to the other end of the bin, the now empty end of the bin from sifting. And I am looking to see how many worms I got. A whole bunch. Oh, here's a breeder adult. See the bulgy clitellum, the yellow tail, red wigglers. That's what we're looking for in adult red wigglers. Okay, so I've got a lot of worms. What I'm looking for, like I said, is how many worms I've got. Do I need to start thinking about splitting this bin? And the answer would be yes. It does need to be split. Here is some skins from the last feeding. Okay, skins, vegetable skins. I'm gonna say it's from the cellulose, but I don't really know. If you know what vegetable skins are made of, let me know. I mean, obviously we can Google it, but if you guys know, that would be really cool to share it with the class. Because vegetable skins take longer to break down. And sometimes, like, especially like tomato skins, they can take months and months to break down. So what I'm doing here is I'm just pulling the skins out that are easy, and I'm going to put them back down in the feed zone. So when the worms migrate to the feed zone to get other foods that I'll put in, they can continue to work on these vegetable skins. Okay. Now, the other thing I'm looking at in here is the moisture level of the material, and it's fairly moist. Okay. So I'm going to want to start drying this down a little bit. I'm also seeing that a lot of this material, again, is castings. So if I start drying this down, I can sift out the castings, which is good for my garden, but also will give me room in the bin to add in new fresh bedding for the worms, which I'm still gonna do tonight, but we wanna just keep that cycle going, right? We add in fresh bedding, they eat it, we, you know, dry it out, we sift it, we move everything down, we put fresh, dry, not dry, but fresh bedding in the working end of the bin, and the worms come over, work on that, and we sift down the section that they just left. So it's just, you know, a rotational cycle that keeps everybody going and happy. Okay. All right. Again, some more adults, but a lot of juveniles. This bin was a nursery bin at the beginning of April. So all of April, May, June, July, and August. So 5 months. So I would expect generally that these worms, I'm gonna start working on, you know, feeding them. I would generally have expected these worms to be bigger and have more adults in here, but, you know, I'm learning too, right? So what I've learned is that I was leaving my cocoon and nursery bins, well, my nursery bins, too crowded for too long. And what was happening is the worms were kind of self-regulating their size because otherwise they would get too cramped. I didn't know worms did that. Okay, folks? Didn't know. So I learned this actually from Ray at Pachamama. I totally suggest you go check him out. He's full of great information as he does his worm journey learning experience. And what he was saying is that, you know, he found that if he split his bins frequently, the worms matured faster. Okay. They just, you know, figured out that, you know, it was okay for them to grow up and then start making their own babies, I guess. So once I, you know, learned that from Ray, I started splitting my bins, and I actually have seen with my own eyes that the less crowded bins, the worms are getting bigger and maturing faster. So there's a tip for you from me by Ray, okay? At, again, Pachamama Worms, and I'll link him down there so you can go check him out. All right, so I'm doing the feed. I put in a base of my pre-compost, which has, you know, lots of biota in it already. Those little colored specks are biota, which the worms eat as food. Then I put down a base layer, absorption layer, I call it, but usually I use a napkin, but this time I actually had some Kleenex. It's not used Kleenex in that regard, guys. Let's not gross ourselves out. But it is Kleenex that I had used to, you know, stuff or layer something. And I came across it when I was doing some cleaning. So I decided, hey, I'm not throwing out perfectly good Kleenex, but I'm not gonna personally use it. So let's put it in the worm bin and see how the worms like it. Then on top of that, I have some super yucky, let me show you, some super yucky potatoes that I cooked in my Instapot in order to hopefully, you know, break it down and, you know, make it more readily edible by the worms versus freezing and thawing and putting it in. So it is a little bit of an experiment, which I also did with the worm bin, the 100 Red Wigglers, the video I put up a couple days ago. I also used the same potatoes in there. So it's a little bit of an experiment to see how Instapotting, pressure cooking, food works for the worms as well. You know, do they get into it pretty quickly or not? We've all seen that non-frozen foods, as opposed to their frozen counterparts. Thank you. Non-frozen ones take a lot longer to break down. So we want to, you know, find new ways of feeding our worms quickly. Okay, worm chow. I think I double dipped there, but that's okay. Azomite and agricultural lime. Both those last two is to provide nice calcium for the worms, nice grit for the worms as well. Double duty there, double prizes. And these worms are almost done. I'm gonna just bring over the compost bucket here so I don't have to go so far. And I'm just gonna cover this up with nice compost. Now, normally I would be using my basic bedding, which is the pre-compost mixed with sifted cow manure, but I'm out of sifted cow manure right now. It is once again raining every freaking day in Florida, so I haven't been able to get out to the pasture and collect dry cow manure. So I'm just making do with pure pre-composted bedding. And again, I have no doubt that the worms are gonna just do fine in it. All right, so there we go. They're fed, they're covered up. Let me get this newspaper back on. You know what? Let me give them some new newspaper. Got some sales circulars in the mail yesterday. And I'm just gonna put them right on top and cover them up and put them away. Let them work on that food and start moving down. May only take them a couple days, and then I can open this up and start drying this down, prepping it for sifting. Okay, so there we go. Another worm bin taken care of for tonight. All right, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please subscribe. Please, you know, give a like, share it so we can get our information out to a wider number of worm wranglers. Okay, so have a good one. I am yours in the dirt, Jayne.